in the way of the action. Because this is serious stuff we're doing here. Serious stuff. I can't see this, so if you have questions, I guess, ask them. I'll answer them. And let's get busy. I'm just correcting the sandwich board here. Basically all I'm doing. Cleaning some things up. And correcting some things. My NPR should be on. That makes sense better. Flux here. Johnson & Johnson trying to pay. It's good. These fumes are just so toxic. Gotta find a better way to get them out of here. If you're out there, you have a way to get rid of fumes, share them. It's toxic for me. I don't like them. Alright, let's give that a shot.
Some people say avoiding full accountability. Again, they will admit no wrongdoing as part of this package.
Okay. NPR addiction correspondent Brian Mann. Thank you, Brian.
Thank you. One of the biggest wildfires in the West is in Oregon, a state that saw major fire destruction last year, too. In the town of Gates, there
wiped out half of the homes in the town of Yates. There were fierce wind
patterns. All right, good. That's all done. That's it. That's how simple it is. I know it makes it look easy, but it's truly not. I'm going to take a look at the rest. Make sure they're on point. Let's clean them up real quick. Got to clean things. Got to make sure it's clean.
Russ Bloomers is an environmental attorney. He's not involved in litigation around the Labor Day fires, but he interviewed eyewitnesses and obtained recordings of 911 calls like these.
We have a downed tree that took out power lines. We have live lines down and
on
fire.
We have
a live
branch
came down and
yeah, that's good.
We have live wires down and on fire. They're sparking. Oh my god, it's so bad out of here.
The utilities chose to shut off power ahead of the record-setting windstorm. Pacific Power did not. This all raised one central question for Bloomers.
Was there a wall of flames or a fire leaping to the community on Labor Day, or were these local officials?
The 911 calls about downed power lines sparking fires began around 7 p.m. At that time, NASA satellite heat maps show the Beechey Creek wildfire is still more than 10 miles east of town. Oregon Public Broadcasting identified 13 power line-related calls and confirmed 3 instances where evidence suggests power lines directly responsible for sparking new fires. One of them was at the firefighting command center.
That's good. Hey, thanks for joining us. Please give us a follow if we can help you. Maybe you got a phone with water damage. Maybe you have a phone that went to another place and they didn't really know what they were doing. Or, hey, you want to give us a shot? Hey, we're here for you. Hey, thanks a lot. Talk to you soon. Take care. Have a good one.